Hey, good morning everyone. My name is Vipin Kumar and in this video we are going to register an app in Azure by using Terraform. Also we are going to use Azure Cloud Shell to invoke Terraform instead of local installation. We are going to configure Terraform state file in Azure storage. You can use this apps to manage your Azure resources. So let's begin. I am using Visual Studio to write Terraform files. Let's walk through Terraform structure and code in Terraform file. This is my Terraform main.tf file. This is my backend configuration settings and I am using Azure storage for the Terraform state file. Before going to modules, let's discuss some other important files. I have provider.tf file. It tells to Terraform to use Azure platform for the resources. I do have many subscription in my environment, so I provided a subscription ID where I do want to create my resources. I am also providing the location, and this location is coming from variables. In the version.tf file, I am providing the required version information for Azure provider. I am using three parameters or variables. A namespace is a environment to which you want to create resources like dev, QA or production. This is the Azure location and type is string. If no value provided by customer, then default location is East US. And another variable is app name. I am providing the parameters or variable for the app registration. This variable will use to provide the display name or name to the app registration in Azure AD. I am providing the values for variables or parameters in terraform.tf vars file. Namespace will be dev, location East US, and app name is web demo. Next one is output file. I will discuss the output later. Let's go back in main.tf file. I am calling a module app registration to register an app in Azure AD, and I am passing a variable value to this module. I have created app registration module in modules directory, and in the app registration modules I have another three files, main, output and variables. In the modules main.tf file, I am creating or register an application with the name of web demo, and this is the property. I am registering an app in Azure AD with the default or basic properties. You can refer Terraform documentation to include more properties for the app registration. This module is required only one variable, that is app name, and value is coming from root module. I am going to redirect the output of this module in this file, and output will be stored in application underscore name. This is the resource type or provider here. This is the resource name. And display name is property or parameters. The value of this combination is going to store in application underscore name for this module. Let's go back the output file in the root module. We are generating the output from module app registration, app name. It is coming from here. Then application name. This is the application name property. The output of module will generate the output of root module. Once Terraform register an app, it also generates a name of the app as a output in the root module. Let's run this Terraform template in Azure Cloud Shell instead of local machine. Before run the Terraform files, we require to create a storage account and container to store the Terraform files. So go to your Azure portal and create a storage account. Select a resource group. I am creating this storage account in resource group name is Terraform, then storage account name. Leave other information as a default. Storage account has been created. Now you require to create a container. I am using the container name TF state. You don't require to create a file inside the container. It is going to create by Terraform automatically with the name dev.terraform.tfstate. Now go ahead and launch a Azure Cloud Shell. If the Azure Cloud Shell is not configured, then you require to configure it. Click on Advanced Settings, select the subscription, use existing, and provide the storage name for the Azure Cloud Shell and provide the file share for the storage account. Go ahead and create it. Cloud Shell has been configured. Now you require to upload Terraform files on Cloud Shell console. This is the folder where my Terraform files is resides. Go ahead and zip the folder. Now you require to upload this zip file on Terraform console. Click on upload and download files button. Okay, file has been uploaded. Let's verify. Let's unzip this file. Okay, files has been unzipped. You can see clearly the benefit to use Azure Cloud Shell. You don't require to manage Azure CLI at your local machine for the Azure resource authentication and authorization. Also, you don't require to install and configure Terraform at your local machine to manage the Azure resources. Terraform version 0.14.7 is installed. That is outdated, but that's okay. Let's initialize the Terraform. It's successfully initialized. Let's go ahead and deploy the resource. It is going to create or register an app in Azure AD. You can see here, app has been registered, and this is the output section. It tells that web demo application apps has been registered in Azure AD. Let's verify. First, verify the state file. My state file should be created in this container. Yes, you can see here dev.terraform.tf state file has been created. Now let's verify the app registration. Go to Azure Active Directory and click on app registration. Then click on all applications and search the app web demo. Yes, you can see here web demo has been created. You can create certificates and secrets and other properties by using Terraform. In this video, I just want to demonstrate how it is easy to integrate Terraform with the Cloud Shell along with the Azure storage. You can create almost all Azure resources with the Terraform. So in this video, that's all. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.